Welcome to the tutorial video on how to create a task with Maps City Map. Before we begin, we need to make sure that preparations are already done. As a preparation, we need to go outside, collect some ideas, take pictures, take measurements, and then we come back and with all the information we have gathered, we can now create tasks. Okay, let's begin. First of all, we start on the main page of the web portal. We can see all the different tabs here, the routes, the tasks, the groups, and we have on the right side the map. Usually I start with going to the location where the task will be later on. So in this case I want to create a task in the downtown of Frankfurt, so I just type Frankfurt into the search and click on the, in this case, in the first results. The map will zoom in. I already know almost where the task will be located, somewhere here in the city center. Now I can go to the tasks, and it's quite easy to create a new task because on top of the list we see a big card with the name new task. We click on it and then we have the possibility to create a new task or a new draft. Later on I would like to explain to you the difference between new draft and a new task. We'll start with the new task. As soon as you click on the new task, a new form will be displayed and it asks you to provide quite a lot of information, but as we will see later on, it is not that much. I recommend to start with the image that you have taken with your smartphone, if possible. So we click on the select image button here and another dialog opens. First of all we click off select image, so we can select an image from our hard drive. In this case I would like to create a task about mailbox. So here's one of the things that has changed from the last web portal version. Now every title image of a trail or of a task has to be in a square format, but you can use our tool to select a section, a square section that should be used as the title image. So in this case I just use drag and drop to make it as big as necessary, and I will focus on the mailbox here. When you are finished, click upload. The good thing about using an image from your smartphone is that usually it contains geolocation information, and we can use it to place the pin where the where the task location should be. So in this case it informs us, do you want the task used in task location? Yes, I want. And the task gets automatically placed there. Now we need to find a title for our task. It will be called mailbox, and I already pre-wrote the task definition. It will be how many times a week does the mailbox gets emptied. So now we continue. The position is already provided through the picture. We have the task type and the solution. In Maps City Map we have at this time three different task types that we can select here. It's the interval, the exact value and the multiple choice, and the fourth one is also available but only through the wizard task, which I will explain in another video. In this case we can actually count the solutions, that's why we have an exact value, and the answer will be 16 as we will see later. Now we can provide a sample solution, and we also should provide it. In this case I will use a picture and text. So again I select an image. And on this image we can see all the necessary information to solve the task. In contrast to the title image, here we don't need a square format image, but we can decide if we actually want to do it or not. So we can here, on pressing this button, we can crop the image or not. Click upload again and it will be displayed here. And for the text, I have also already prepared something. In this section, we can provide some hints for the students, and we can decide on of which type the hints should be. We have the possibility to provide text, picture, or video hints. In this case, I would like to give a hint, a text hint. So, how many times a day does the mailbox get emptied? I add another hint. Is there a difference between weekday and weekend? So of course it's a question. I can add some metadata if I want. So for example, the about this object field is for adding information. Maybe you have some historical information. For in this case, I don't have any for the mailbox, but maybe you have some nice object where you want to add something. Now I can decide for which school level the task will be. In this case, it's a primary task, primary level task, so maybe it's for grade 2. Here I can decide if the students will need some special tools to be able to solve the task, but in this case we don't even need a calculator, we don't need nothing actually, a little bit of paper and pen, and that's okay. Now I can use some text to make a little classification of the task. In this task I have the counting and maybe the mailbox as an object. The author name and email is automatically provided from your account, but you can change it if you want. When you think you are done, then you can press the create button. After a short time it will be created and the portal will redirect you to the task detail view. As you can see, the task will get an own URL with a code, and we have all the information that we entered. So we have the title mailbox, how many times a week does the mailbox get emptied, we have the tags, we have the recommended grade, and all the stuff is right here. Okay, that was how we can create a normal task. I would like to go back, and we had also the possibility to create a draft. Now let's imagine I am outside going down the street and I see this mailbox and I have the idea, oh, I can do a Math City Map task here, but of course I don't have the time to sit down and formulate everything in a nice way here. So what I want to do is just to make a quick sketch or a quick draft of the task and then maybe later on continue working on it from home. So usually I will be, when I'm on the outside, I will be on my phone, so I would like to simulate this. Could look like this, yeah. So I press here on my phone, I press new task, new draft, and again I can select an image. If I would be really on my phone, I could also take an image directly with the camera and select it then, and I will just select the image. Oh, that was the wrong image, sorry, this is already the sample solution image. I'd like to select this image here. Again, I need to make to select a square section, which I would like to use as the title. And as soon as I'm done, I click upload. Again, the system asks me if I want to look, if I want like to use the geolocation. Of course, I want, so I press yes. If you want to check now where the task is located on the smartphone, you can click on the right hand bottom corner on the blue button and it will switch to the map view. So you can see again I am still in Frankfurt, so everything is fine. Clicking again, I will switch back to the list. So now I only provide okay, this task will be about mailbox, and the task will be about counting empty times. So just like some notes for me to work on the task later. And that's basically all. So I can provide an image, a short title and a short note on the definition of the task, and then I create the task. I go back to my overview of my tasks, and what you can see now is that this task that I have created is marked as a draft. So this does mean the task is not completed yet, and it will also not be possible to add it to a trail actually. So when I'm at home, let's assume I'm at home already, so I cancel this one here, I'm at my big screen here, and at home I can just open the task again and click the edit task button to continue working on it. Now I could change all the information. The exact value is also not correct, so by default we say 42 is the answer to everything, so the 42 is also the answer to a draft task. As soon as you're done, you should, because the answer will be 16, you click on save, and now the task is not a draft anymore. So if I go back, it will be not marked as a draft.